Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the most electrifying retrograde season video from 14th and 15th almost of May. Three planets will be starting their retrogression movements, and they are Venus, Saturn, and Jupiter. And from roughly 15th, or you could say night of 14th or morning of 15th, you will be experiencing these retrograde energies. And these retrogrades are very crucial because Jupiter, Venus, Jupiter, Saturn, these two goes retrograde always for a long time, but Venus goes retrograde not very frequently, unlike Mercury. So Venus goes retrograde once in 18 months. So now is the time that it is again going to be retrograde, and maybe by the time you see this video, it is already retrograde. So therefore, Venus will now be retrograde in its sign of Taurus. And last time, 2018, it was retrograde in the sign of Libra. So therefore, this is the time when Jupiter and Venus both will be retrograde. So generally, Jupiter is retrograde for 3 to 4 months, but Venus is not retrograde at that same time. So if both of them go retrograde together, then this becomes a very crucial time. And along with that, when Jupiter is retrograde, near about Saturn also goes retrograde. So therefore, we have to analyze what these retrograde motions will do or could do for us, okay? Because what ultimately they will end up doing is dependent on your own horoscope. Do you have Jupiter, Venus, or Saturn retrograde in your horoscope? If yes, then this will affect you more. Now, the moment I say it will affect you, many times people become fearful. They think, oh, we will die, we'll be fired, we will have an accident, somebody will murder us. No, nothing of that sort will happen. You don't have to fear unnecessarily. Effective means the energies will, the retrograde energies will affect you. Okay. Now, retrograde, people think that retrograde means bad. Actually, there is no scripture statement which supports this. So this is another cooked up idea from YouTube astrology that retrograde means bad. Vakri means very dangerous. Okay. There's no scriptural verdict which says this. So this has no basis from the authorized scriptures like Brihat Parashar Hora Shastra, for example. So I do not buy into such fancy ideas that retrograde means bad. Okay. In fact, in my experience, I have seen retrograde planets are extremely good. Now, the moment I say they are extremely good, you will start asking, are benefics becoming retrograde, is that good or bad? Are malefics, if they retrograde, if it is good or bad? What if the benefic is a natural benefic, but he is a functional malefic, like Jupiter rules the 12th house, for example, for Capricorn Lagna? What if it is a natural malefic, Saturn, but if it rules a trine, like for example Taurus Lagna, it rules the 9th house and it also rules the 10th. So unlimited what ifs can be there, but irrespective of that, I have seen retrograde planets are very good. Now, I would like to clarify my statement. What do I mean when I say retrograde planets are good? Good doesn't mean it will give you a love partner, or you will become a millionaire, or all your worries and anxieties will go. That is not what is the meaning of the word good. When I say good, now you may have a different meaning of what is good. You may think that, oh, if I sleep in a bed of money or gold, then only then that is good for me. Well, then that's fine. You are free to define what you think is good and bad for you. I have nothing against it. But I would like to clarify what I mean when I say good. See, first try to understand what is retrogression actually. What is retrogression? Retrogression means, I have said this many times in many of my videos, I am repeating here again. Suppose you are going out somewhere and suddenly you remember that you missed something. Then you come back and you get that. So now from an absolute sense, you could say, oh, that's terrible. I have to waste time coming back and then double the time is gone. If you look from an absolute sense, well, yes, that is not good. But if you look at yourself at that particular point of time, then when you realize that you missed something, then you go back and get it. So is it good or bad? In my opinion, I have seen that gives very good results. Results means, again, result doesn't mean some external result. It also doesn't mean some internal changes. What it means is a retrograde planet forces you, doesn't inspire you. The retrograde planets will force you to do things which you ignored. Yes, that is why they are fantastic, in my opinion. So whichever houses retrograde planets rule in your chart, they will force you to make changes in life which you do not like, which not that you don't like, but you did not do out of your laziness or irresponsibility. A retrograde planet means you are irresponsible. Okay. Now, what does it mean you are irresponsible? Suppose your 10th lord is retrograde. Does it mean you are irresponsible in career? If your 7th lord is retrograde, does it mean you are irresponsible in marriage? Well, could be if the overall chart suggests. But it could also mean that your married life is fine, it's going great. Many people have Venus retrograde, 7th lord retrograde. So it can happen that their married life is going fine, but there is something which they need to do to take the marriage to the next level. See, a planet is not just, it's not just great to not have anything bad, okay? Like sometimes people tell me that, oh, actually, I am very spiritual, you know? I said, okay, yes, nice to know that. What kind of practices are you doing? What is your lifestyle? No, actually, I am a vegetarian, you know? So I am very spiritual. All vegetarians are very spiritual. And I'm like, okay. what makes you come to that conclusion? Then these people tell me sometimes that no, vegetarian means, you know, I don't kill anybody, I'm nice, you know, I like animals, I let them live, you know, you stay happy, I stay happy. Tum bhi theek, main bhi theek, aap bhi theek, main bhi theek. Ye bhi theek hai, wo bhi theek hai, sab theek hai. Well, definitely, it's great to follow Ahimsa. As the saying goes, Ahimsa Parmo Dharma, and it's very good. At the same time, just by being non-violent, it doesn't mean that you have elevated yourself spiritually, because non-violence is level zero. Level zero means that's bare minimum for you to start spiritual life. Okay, so if anybody claims that they are eating meat and they are elevating themselves spiritually, they are themselves in illusion, they are in Maya, they are lying to themselves basically. Okay, so imagine this. So therefore, when a seventh lord of a person's horoscope is retrograde, it may not mean the person is just not doing anything in marriage. It can mean many things, something like this. So just because you don't eat meat, it doesn't mean that you have elevated greatly spiritually. Okay, that's the starting point. After that, you have to do spiritual practices over which you will elevate yourself, by which you can elevate yourself actually. So therefore, a planet, if it is retrograde, if it is Lord of the Seventh, it can mean so many things. Okay, maybe by dint of your karma, your dashas are indicating the second house or the seventh house or the 11th house, your upcoming Mahadashas. And that's why your married life is stable enough. But if the seventh lord is retrograde, still there could be certain behaviors which you actually need to change, but you are reluctant to change, without which the marriage cannot go to a different level. And therefore, when you run, now the next question people ask is what happens when how do we get the results of retrograde plans? Well, very simple. In the dashas, okay, in the Mahadasha or Antar Dasha or even Pratyantar, But Mahadasha and Pratyantar is difficult to judge at a physical level. So I give more focus to the Antardashas when studying retrograde planets. So suppose your Saturn is retrograde, then in Antardashas you will feel that more. Okay. So therefore, retrograde planets, in my opinion, they are the most fantastic planets because they force you to make those changes in life, which will without which you cannot go to the next level. Now, having said that, when you currently see that Jupiter and Venus are retrograde, so what does this mean? Jupiter and Venus are retrograde. Jupiter and Venus controls all the good things in life. I had made a video on greatest blessings of Jupiter and Venus. If you have not watched it, please go and watch. So in that, I said that anything good that you have in life, you know, anything that looks good, sounds good, smells good, tastes good, feels good, intellectually, mentally, physically, anything actually, anything and everything is under these two planets. If these two planets were not there, the world would be like a dead, it would be like Smashan actually, like a graveyard, because there would be no life in this world. These two planets, they give life actually. Jupiter is Jiv Karak. He is the significator of light actually. He is the significator of the soul. Because when the soul is in the spiritual world, in Vaikuntha, then it's pure consciousness. That's known as Chit. But when this soul manifests in this material realm, it becomes Chitta. Chitta means contaminated material contaminated consciousness, which means I am identifying with this finger. Okay, so I just got a small cut, if you can see here. So now if I touch this place, it hurts me. Okay, this is almost 1 or 2 days back. Now, why does it hurt me? No cut here, it doesn't hurt me. But why does this cut hurt me so much? Because I am identifying that I, who is somebody, is actually this body, who actually I am not. So that is what is Chitta, means my consciousness has become contaminated to think that I am this body. Janasya moho yam aham mameti. This is what the Srimad Bhagavatam says. And therefore, we get pain and pleasure. Okay. Now, when suppose this cut heals, this wound heals completely, then I will feel nice. Why? Because some pain has gone away. Or suppose I eat something very nice, I will get pleasure from the tongue. I listen to something very nice, then I get pleasure from my ears. So then what happens? I experience happiness and distress simultaneously, right? And all the pleasures and happiness of this world, Jupiter and Venus, they are controlling these pleasures, okay? So if Jupiter is not there, there are no living beings. Everybody is dead, out. And then Venus gives life to things. Okay, Venus represents those things without which this world will still be there, but there won't be much charm in this world. Okay, so therefore Jupiter and Venus, they are very important actually, and when they go retrograde, it's a very good time for us to ponder what are the things that we need to do to make our lives more happier, more better, more fulfilled as an individual. And these retrogrades are even more important because these are happening in very crucial signs. If you see Saturn and Venus, they are going retrograde in their own signs, Capricorn and Taurus. Okay, and Jupiter is getting retrograde in its sign of debilitation. So therefore, whenever a planet goes retrograde in its sign of debility, so the intensity is very high because now you think that imagine you went somewhere and you realize you missed something, but then you realize that not only did you miss that, but you also don't have time to get that back. So then how fast will you run, right? So this is the example of a planet which is retrograde in its sign of debility. For example, Jupiter is in Capricorn now. So therefore, we have to realize that the houses which Jupiter rules in our chart, there could be a sense of urgency regarding those houses, and there could be massive changes depending on your dashas. Okay, so whatever happens in your life will be based on your dashas. Okay, not retrogrades or not transits. Your dashas will ultimately decide what happens. And Venus represents the things which give us pleasure at a mundane level, and Jupiter is pleasure at a higher level. Okay, so even at a mundane level, we have to see the things which we have been doing wrong, because of which we have become more unhappy. So now is the time that we try to introspect, and because Taurus represents food and drinks, it is especially a very good time to recollect and try to think the lifestyle that we are leading actually during this lockdown or any other period in general also. What are the things which we are eating? Are we eating a nice vegetarian diet? Are we eating vegetables? Are we eating properly? Are we eating a balanced diet? Are we taking the necessary nutrients which are required? So these are the things which we should ask ourselves. And if we feel that no, we are not taking these things, then now is the time that we should change. Now you may think, oh, what is this? Ah, just food changes. Venus retrograde, only food. Well, do not forget, you are what you eat. Yes, you are what you eat. The body and the mind which you have is a result of your dietary choices. So food is very, very, very crucial. So do not think that, Venus retrograde in Taurus, is he talking, how does he say, only food? I thought some big things will happen. No, big things may happen. That's not important. Important is what is happening in your life. Some government may collapse or some ship may collapse and 1,000 people may die. But how is it affecting your life? 1,000 people losing their life somewhere, some president falling down from somewhere. Whatever it is, but is it making you a better person? Or somebody gets a Nobel Prize, is that affecting your life? Anything good happening or anything bad happening to somebody, is it making your life better? Okay. So Venus retrograde means you have to ask these questions, and Jupiter retrograde will come to Saturn now. And Jupiter retrograde in Capricorn. So the houses which Jupiter rules in your chart, since the time Jupiter had entered Capricorn, you might have felt that there is a sense of hopelessness regarding those houses. At least people who I know of, they have told me that, like some Sagittarius Lagna people have told me, they don't know where their life is going. They are confused. Why? Because the Lagnesh is in debility. So this confusion is there. They are feeling hopeless, helpless, and not very positive at least. Okay. Now depends on your dashas also. If your dashas are difficult, then this really happens. Otherwise, if dashas are good, then you won't face this headlessness. Even though you are a Sagittarius or a Pisces rising, okay, it won't happen. Now you will see that it will go back to Sagittarius. Okay, so therefore, after this retrogression, you will see that the Mool Trikon energy is back, which means you will be reinstantiated to your faith, because the sign gives you belief and faith, and the house gives you the results. Okay, so many times people ask me, a debilitated planet in the 10th house, is it good or bad for career? Well, it is very good for career because it is sitting in the 10th house, because the results will come from the house. And what does it mean that you have a debilitated planet even though you are having great career success? Well, you are not doing it. It could have many meanings. It could mean that although you are becoming successful, but you are not happy. This is not something which you wanted. Many times people tell me, I got this, I got that, but this is not what I wanted. So the awareness comes, the happiness, the joy, the sense of peace and comfort comes from the sign, and the house gives the external results. Okay. And then we have the master of karma, the most dreaded, feared, malefic, the, according to some people, the terrorizer. And who is that? He's Shani Maharaj himself. So Saturn is also going to be retrograde, and therefore, and in fact, Saturn is already retrograde now. He is very, very, very happy in his own sign, and therefore, the houses which Saturn rules in your chart, you will get a feeling that you really need to become more strict regarding those houses. Okay, if you are just sitting in the couch and watching TV, it may not work for you. All right, so therefore, this is a very good time to do austerities, to do fasting, and Pandav Nirjal Ekadashi is also around the corner somewhere in June. So I will make a video on it. So therefore, this is the best time that you have a disciplined life. You get up early in the morning and you chant your mantras. You read scriptures like the Bhagavad Gita. It's very essential. And then you really try to introspect. When Saturn gets retrograde, one very important thing you should be doing is you should always try to check which are the things that I should put effort in my life. Okay, because you only have 24 hours. You cannot put effort in every area of life. That's not possible simultaneously. So therefore, you have to decide when Saturn goes retrograde, which things will I prioritize at the top? Okay. So for example, let's go to Bhagavad Gita here. In the third chapter, 14th shloka here. अन्नाद् भवन्ति भूतानि पर्जन्यादन्न संभवः यज्ञाद् भवति पर्जन्यो यज्ञ कर्म समुद्भवः. All living bodies subsist on food grains. Wow. Which are produced from rains. Rains are produced by performance of yajna, sacrifice, and yajna is born of prescribed duties. Evam parampara praptam. So many beautiful shlokas are there. Then the next shloka talks of karma, you see. So therefore, it's important that you read shlokas like this where you can understand. Because now you may be thinking, what's the connection of Gita and prioritizing my life? Well, the Gita will help you prioritize things, because the Gita will give you a good direction in. Because see, Arjuna was so powerful, he was known as Savyasachi. He was also known as Jishnu. Jishnu means one who is unconquerable. But why was he lamenting like this? Because he was not prioritizing properly. He was prioritizing his emotions more than his duty, which can be very dangerous for a Kshatriya especially. So therefore, Krishna helped him to prioritize. Krishna told that, no, even if Drona and Bhishma are your worshipable elders and gurus, but because they are on the side of Adharma, you must fight and kill them. So Krishna helped him to prioritize. So therefore, if you also want to put efforts, it's very good to put efforts, but don't just put efforts without knowing anything. You have to know that where are your efforts leading to finally? Where is it culminating? If you do not get that, then maybe your efforts go in vain. Alright, so make sure that you cross every step and you go stepwise. But how should you do that? Well, Saturn is going to be retrograde for a long time. So therefore, you should read scriptures like the Bhagavad Gita. It's very essential, okay? And at the end, I would say, if you want to chant certain mantras, you can chant. For Saturn, you can chant Om Namo Narayanaya. Then for Jupiter, you can chant Om Namo Bhagavate Shri Vamanaya. And for Venus, you can chant Om Namo Bhagavate Rishikeshaya. These three mantras. Every day morning, you can chant for 108 times. Okay. You can chant this for minimum 6 months, 3 months, 6 months at least. Okay. So that will really help you. And that is it from my side. So these retrograde periods are beautiful periods where we are forced to make changes so that we take our life to the next level. All right. So do not curse retrograde planets. Do not think they are bad. Think they are your friends. They are trying to remind you of certain things which you lost. And we know the example of Hanumanji. Okay. So Hanumanji was cursed by the rishis that you will forget all your power, and when the right time comes, somebody will remind you of them. So similarly, Jambavan reminded him. So like Jambavan reminded Hanumanji, similarly, we also have to remind ourselves. Maybe we have Jambavan somewhere, you know, some senior or maybe our gurus, they can remind us of our powers which we actually have, and this is what retrograde planets do. All right, so therefore utilize this time properly, don't waste it, and do spiritual activities and prioritize your life properly. Have a good schedule in the morning especially, okay, and eat good food and connect to God spiritually, because Jupiter is also retrograde in its sign of debilitation. All right, that is it from my side. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this transit, you can visit my website. You will find it down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him.